We look forward to seeing more Nigerian companies investing in South Africa.
Hey guys! Hi, bo. Hi, bo. Hey, good. Good. Hey, I want to dance on my piano like this. How did the dancer? Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. My name is Princess Banigo and you're welcome to Banigo's TV. So today we're talking about the gist that got South Africans shaking. In their legs, they shake. So our president, when are they? Well, that doesn't know they do it, but this one do it. He went to South Africa, okay, he went to France, and then right now, he went to South Africa, and then the meeting that came outside from him going to South Africa, well, let's listen to what South African president had to say.
With these efforts to improve the ease of doing business in South Africa, we want to enable investors to promote and operate their businesses in a manner that will enable them to pursue various opportunities in various sectors of the economy. We look forward to seeing more Nigerian companies investing in South Africa. In fact, we want to see Nigerian products on the shelves of South African shops. Our efforts to create a favorable environment include our simplified visa process for Nigerian business people to travel to South Africa, qualifying Nigerian business people can be granted a 5-year multiple entry visa. In addition, tourists from Nigeria are now able to apply for a visa without even submitting a passport. We expect that this 11th session of our Binational Commission will enable us to consolidate cooperation in a number of other areas. Our government continues with its efforts.
So you guys heard what the South African president said concerning Nigerian businesses. See, I'm going to say, if you're a Nigerian and you want to do business in any country, please go in the right way. I am not of, you know, the motion that you migrate or you go illegally into any man's country. If South Africans are opening their doors to Nigerians to come and do business and they're saying they want to give us 5-year visas or whatnot, fine, go legitimately, do the right things, don't constitute nuisance in their country, be a good citizen, you know, represent Nigeria well, even when you're in South Africa. I am for all the good stuff, right? So big ups to the South African president for what he has come out to say, encouraging Nigerians. I'm glad that, you know, it's just social media war at the end of the day. The president, the country is still going to function. But this information came outside and a lot of, you know, Nigerians took it in a certain way, and then the South Africans also took it in a certain way. I am here with those videos for us to watch and give our 2 cents. Let's go watch what people talked about this, the South Africans, the Nigerians. Let's go watch and I'll be back.
President Ramaphosa co-chaired the 11th session of the Binational Commission between the Federal Republic of Nigeria and South Africa in Cape Town today. Nigerian President Bola Tinubu was also in attendance. International Relations Minister Ronald Lamola said this year marks 30 years since the two countries established diplomatic relations following decades of Nigeria's relentless support for the anti-apartheid struggle in South Africa, a gesture he says we will always cherish. In terms of economic benefits, South Africa enjoys access to Nigeria's population of approximately 234.6 million people, which provides a vast market for South Africa's manufactured goods and services. Notable service companies which have tapped into Nigeria's consumer base include MTN and ShopRite. South African firms have also invested heavily in Nigeria's banking sector, generating significant revenue and expanding regional influence. President Ramaphosa said South Africa would like to see more Nigerian companies investing in the country, as well as more Nigerian products on South African shelves. Qualifying business people will be able to apply for a 5-year multiple entry visa to enable business in various sectors. Nigerian tourists will now be able to apply for visas without the need to submit passports physically at visa processing centers.
To some interesting developments between Nigeria and South Africa, South African President Cyril Ramaphosa has announced that Nigerian travelers can now apply for South African visas without having to submit their passports. Now, this announcement was made during the 11th session of the Nigeria-South Africa Binational Commission in Cape Town, where Nigerian President Bola Tinubu was present. Ramaphosa says South Africa has simplified the visa process to make it easier for Nigerian tourists and business people to travel. For business owners, there's even a new 5-year multiple entry visa option, making it easier to do business between the two nations. In addition to the visa changes, Ramaphosa stressed South Africa's commitment to removing barriers to investment, hoping to strengthen economic ties between both nations. He highlighted the 30 years of diplomatic relations between South Africa and Nigeria, noting that while there's been great progress, there's still work to be done to improve the business climate. South Africa is also hoping to see more Nigerian companies investing in the country.
Guys, watching this video has made me so excited. I am so thrilled. I didn't listen to the full video, I just heard this little clip, and I am so thrilled. I'm so proud of our government for taking the step. I don't know much about economics. I'm not going to talk about corruption. I'm not going to talk about illegal migrants. We have exhausted all of those conversations, but the conversation that South Africans don't have enough is recognizing Nigeria for the giant that it is. If we were to have a first world country in this continent, Nigeria has all the makings for it. There's 230 million plus people that these people are trying to open up economic activity to, economic access to, for everyone, for Nigerians and for South Africans. And we have a problem. Nigeria is a giant, guys, and we need to come to terms with that. Don't comment on my post about Nigerians do this, they don't do this. South Africans do the same thing when they go to other people. Everyone does the same thing when they go to somebody else's country. I don't want to have that conversation. That's a boring conversation. I want to have a conversation about what it will do for two African countries to start amazing economic activity with each other. I will repeat it. Nigeria has all the makings of a first world country, guys, and we need to just accept that fact. They are 100 million short of the same population as America. With that said, I want to say again, I am proud of this government. Like, I am so proud. I'm so happy to be alive in this very moment where we start to look at each other and ask ourselves, like, why are we not working together more as Africans? I am so proud.
So President Ramaphosa announced today that he was going to ease the visa requirements for Nigerian citizens, and also he's going to ease the process in terms of if they're applying for visa, nothing much is required. And also if the tourists from Nigeria, they don't struggle. Then he went on and said he wants to see more Nigerians and their stock in South Africa. And I didn't make this video. I saw this earlier, but I didn't make a video on purpose because I thought it was going to trend. But now I'm seeing that it's not trending. And I'm just thinking to myself, imagine if Julius Malema said this. I'm going to play you guys the video. Imagine if Julius Malema said this. The president, Cyril Ramaphosa,
is giving access to Nigerians for them to do business, for them to travel easily to South Africa, for them when they apply for the visa. I think here at the end he said that they won't need to give their passports. He's just creating an easy way for them to travel. If Julius Malema said this last week or last of last week, it was Leon Schreiber extending a visa for Zimbabweans. If Julius Malema said this, you all be going crazy. You would be spiraling right now. You want to tell us you care for South Africa. You guys are two-faced. You only care for South Africa when it's Julius Malema who says something. If anybody else says the same thing, it's okay. Hypocrites. Let me listen to Ramaphosa and let me know what you think in the comment section. Whoa! Shame. Why? Oh, I don't know what CIC has done. I don't know. Ukutumtana bantu yintoni lingaka. You?
We look forward to seeing more Nigerian companies investing in South Africa. In fact, we want to see Nigerian products on the shelves of South African shops. Our efforts to create a favorable environment include our simplified visa process for Nigerian business people to travel to South Africa, qualifying Nigerian business people can be granted a 5-year multiple entry visa. In addition, tourists from Nigeria are now able to apply for a visa without even submitting a passport.
The only South African president where is a bit better thing, like with this Cyril Ramaphosa. You see the way the man they talk. Say he wants to strengthen ties with Nigerians because he no waiting the Naija. He no waiting the Naija. How many Nigerian businesses there South Africa? But South Africa has over 120 businesses in Nigeria. He knows that when Nigeria tell those businesses to return back home, that money where visa they carry, they give those people for South Africa, that money no go come out again. Because all their businesses don't return back home. So I am asking you South Africans, who need each other more? You guys need Nigeria more. Because if Nigeria needed you people more, we go get the 120 businesses in your country. But this one, how many Nigerian businesses are in South Africa? They're not up to 10. But South Africa has over 120 businesses in Nigeria. Nice read about Ramaphosa, they don't say, if one day give visa to Nigerians, may then come South Africa. In one day, that's tourism. If you are a tourist, you as a Nigerian, you want to visit South Africa as a tourist, you should go there. Now, what is Cyril Ramaphosa they talk? Now, you see so many people, they cry under the comment section. Oh, ACN, oh, we should vote this man out. We should do this one. They don't know, say, when Nigerians, they parana, tell those their businesses, send me then go. That government benefit, where they get, they not go get them again. These people, yeah, they know, I think see one says they know get. I've been more than listening to what Ramaphosa they talk.
Our government continues with its efforts to improve the ease of doing business in South Africa. We want to enable investors to promote and operate their businesses in a manner that will enable them to pursue various opportunities in various sectors of the economy. We look forward to seeing more Nigerian companies investing in South Africa. In fact, we want to see Nigerian products on the shelves of South African shops. Our efforts to create a favorable environment include our simplified visa process for Nigerian business people to travel to South Africa. Qualifying Nigerian business people can be granted a 5-year multiple entry visa. In addition, tourists from Nigeria are now able to apply for a visa without even submitting a passport. We expect that this 11th session of our Binational Commission will enable us to consolidate cooperation in a number of other areas.
Good news, guys, good news. So South African government have just introduced 5 years multiple entry visa for Nigerians. And they even went as far as dropping off passport submission. Like, this is very good. Now, to Nigerians, if you wish to travel to South Africa at this moment, please, when you get to South Africa, respect the law, respect the people. Don't misuse this opportunity. It is not easy for Nigerian government to get a South African government to sign a deal like this. Please, as a Nigerian, respect the law while you are in South Africa. These 5 years is enough. Like, this is very good. With 5 years visa, you can go into South Africa and come out. You go in and come out. Nobody will disturb you. As long as you're doing the right thing while you're in South Africa, the South Africans will not come for you. The government will not come for you. As long as you abide by the law. Now, some Nigerians will say this is not something to celebrate, or South Africa is not that special. Listen, some people are praying for God every day to grant them visa to enter South Africa. All right? And I know that some South Africans are not happy, but we must understand that South Africa and Nigeria need each other diplomatically. And for the sake of the African continent, we need each other as well. So we may not agree on certain things, but sometimes the beauty of diversity is to agree and disagree and still be able to move on. All right, so shout out to the South African government and shout out to our government, Nigerian government. And Mr. President, I thank you for this.
South Africa to ease visa rules, boost trade with Nigeria. President Cyril Ramaphosa announced efforts to introduce a simplified 5-year multiple entry visa for Nigerian tourists, removing the requirements to submit passports. He also stressed the importance of enhancing trade, stating we want Nigerian products on South African shelves. I don't know how this benefits South Africans. I don't know, because if you go to Cars World in Midrand, you'll find that a lot of apartments are filled with Nigerian scammers in Midrand, and some places in Cape Town, even in Durban. And I'm just trying to ask myself, like, how does this benefit South Africans, you know? Because I don't know any South African that wants to go to Nigeria and, like, for a visit. I don't know. I've never met anyone. Unless it's like a gold digger that's dating a Nigerian, you know, and she feels obligated to go there because her Nigerian boyfriend is like, we have to go back to Nigeria. But I don't know any South Africans that wants to go to Nigeria. But at this point, I don't care. I don't care, because you people clearly don't care about this country when it comes to voting. Maybe there's going to be a huge difference within the next coming years. We'll see with the next elections how you guys will decide. But I'll tell you this right now, a lot of South Africans are not going to be happy about this. They're not. But it's okay. You know what I mean?
Oh, wow! Nigerians can now visit South Africa with ease, without any stress. All thanks to the president of South Africa, President Cyril Ramaphosa. Guys, let me tell you this good news. Today, President Cyril Ramaphosa has declared that entry to South Africa is now very easy. You can apply for visa to South Africa if you are a business person that want to visit South Africa, or you are a tourist. You can apply for your visa without your passport. They don't need your passport anymore. To make it very easy for you to enter South Africa, you don't need a passport again. It was said today, this was confirmed today, that Nigerians who are tourists, who are business people that want to visit South Africa, can do that without their passport now. They can apply for visas without their passport, and it will be granted without wasting any time. And not only that, he also said that he has approved a 5 years multiple entry visa. Isn't this a good news, guys? This is the time for you to start applying, to start making that move now before they change their mind. And this was said today, like I said, on the opening of the 11th section of the Nigerian South Africa Binational Commission, which happened in Cape Town, and our president was there. Bola Ahmed Tinubu was there. So this is actually a good news to some of us. To some of us that want to visit South Africa. And they've been delaying us a long time ago. This is the time now.
The sectors of the economy. We look forward to seeing more Nigerian companies investing in South Africa. In fact, we want to see Nigerian products on the shelves of South African shops. Our effort.
Okay, that's it. I'm moving to South Africa. I'm coming, bro. I'm coming. We're brothers. We're brothers. I'm moving. Woo! The South African government have done, if you can't beat them, you join them. They realize the economy is shambles. They can't beat the superpower of Nigeria. So they are joining. You guys should be lucky you don't have Nigeria trying to visit that your dead country, bro. That your country that is a deep hole. Your country is like a cramped fist jungle. You should be lucky that you have Nigerians with their money trying to come and invest in your country. You should be begging us, bro. Keep your ego aside. We all know your boys are broke. We are the big boys. You guys are the peasants. Yeah? Stay in your lane, bro. Stay in your lane. Bug off.
Our government continues with its efforts to improve the ease of doing business in South Africa. We want to enable investors to promote and operate their businesses in a manner that will enable them to pursue various opportunities in various sectors of the economy. We look forward to seeing more Nigerian companies investing in South Africa. In fact, we want to see Nigerian products on the shelves of South African shops. Our efforts to create a favorable environment include our simplified visa process for Nigerian business people to travel to South Africa, qualifying Nigerian business people can be granted a 5-year multiple entry visa. In addition, tourists from Nigeria are now able to apply for a visa without even submitting a passport. We expect that this 11th session of our Binational Commission will enable us to consolidate cooperation in a number of other areas.
Hello everybody, welcome to the Controversial Podcast. My name is Eje Mutemana. Thank you for joining me. It is a wonderful day on this episode, by the way. I just want to say this is a spectacular news, a wonderful news for all the Nigerians living to South Africa, despite of the fact that Nigerians are the most hated foreigners in South Africa right now. And majority of black South Africans, my brothers, would wish Nigerians could back and leave. However, they are proven to be wrong, because now the number one citizen is actually inviting them. And inviting them what? It's saying they don't even need to submit a passport if they want to visit South Africa when they apply for a visa. You know what does this mean? They cannot even be denied a visa to come. Also, they said products from Nigeria, like these things you eat in Nigerian restaurants, Nigerian foods and what, they need to get to the shelves of South Africa. You know what does that mean? No matter how we as people don't get along with one another, there are people who understand the importance of working with your own brothers. No matter how bad they are or how good they are, in working with them is beneficial. And I think the president realized he cannot rely on white people that much. This one proves that you can only rely on your brothers. You can only rely on people of your skin color. You can only rely on people that you know. This part of the fact that you do not agree with them. But I think the president is starting realizing that many of the things that probably Nigerians are accused of is just propaganda. And they are bigger fishes into the fish tank than Nigerians. Otherwise, he wouldn't have just slapped the rest of my South African brothers on the face and bring Nigerians knowingly that they hate Nigerians so much. You know what I mean? So, yeah, it's wonderful news for Nigerians, and we would like to see more African countries get more of this. We need goods that are manufactured in the rest of Africa. The way goods that are manufactured in South Africa goes into Africa, the rest also can come to South Africa, and maybe we can contain some of the animals. If you know very well, most of the foods in Nigeria, most of the foods in DRC and the other countries are not genetically modified, which means if their products, their food and stuff start getting to the shelves of South Africa, we're going to limit a lot of cancers, we're going to limit a lot of unnecessary diabetes and diseases, because the majority of food that people are eating in South Africa that are manufactured with the West, yeah, they taste nice and good and everything, but they're genetically modified, which means they make people sick anyway. So having to turn into some of the foods that are in the continent, Southern Africa is very infected because of the food that people are eating. So bringing the food from the West Africa, East Africa, Central Africa, if it gets to the shelves here in South Africa, eventually we're going to limit many diseases. I know many people will bet to differ, but it is the reality though.
You heard it. What were your thoughts? The South Africans, they don't want this to happen. Like, they are saying, is there a way they can sign petition? Some of them are even calling Julius Malema in this, that, oh, if it was Julius who said this, what's going to be happening if it was Julius? Because Julius is pro, you know, let's blacks support blacks and whatnot, you know. But what are your thoughts concerning this as a Nigerian, as a South African? What do you think about this? Do you think this is a wrong? If you're a South African, do you think this is wrong, what your president is doing? I don't think it's wrong. And if you're Nigerian, do you think, oh, this is a good one? And as a Nigerian citizen, as I said, if you're going to go, please, you guys represent our country well by doing the right thing in South Africa so that we can avoid this unnecessary hatred that South Africans have for us. I mean, at the end of the day, we might never be able to avoid it, but it is what it is. But just go and do the right thing there. I think this is a great one. I think I would consider visiting South Africa. I don't have any business to go and do the Esha, so it might be a while. Maybe when I want to go and push my hair business in South Africa, because the president said he wants to see South Africa, Nigerian's brand on the shelves and whatnot. So it's about time I think I broaden my horizon and take this my hair business to South Africa so that people can come and buy hair. South Africans come and buy hair from me. Anyway, guys, I think it's a great one, really, if you ask me. But I want to know your thoughts in the comment section. Let me know, and I'll see you guys in my very next video. Bye for now.
Your Excellency. Hi. Very well. How are you, my brother?
I'm okay.
Good to see you.
Good to see you too.
Always good to see you.
Thank you.
Always good to see you. Are you well?
I'm well. I came from France.
Oh, you came from France?
Yes.
That's
a 11 hours.
11 hours? That's a long trip. That's a long, long trip. They want to take their pound of flesh.